My kids are crazy, man.
Melky, are you okay?
Is she okay? What are we gonna do if we have to bring her back like this?
Melky.
This is really weird. Why is she doing this shit? Why is she doing this? Why are you answering me? Is she being crazy? Does she usually do this? Is this some type of syndrome? Shh.
Melky.
On top of all of them at all times during the intervention, okay? This isn't just a make it or break it moment for Melky. This is a make it or break it moment for us too, all right?
I know we've had our differences, but it's like we've been to hell and back together. Like we're going to the army and we're going to war and
we're fighting terrorists here. So I have your backs. I can only hope that you have mine.
Mamono, I'm ready. Suit, shape. Oh, maybe not shave, but suit, a little hair of the dog, and booyah, ready to rock and roll. Hey, I just want to warn you that I may have some emotional moments in there, and you know, just be prepared.
My lady.
What do you think you do?
What? Abuela, ¿cómo está, abuela?
Hola, amor.
Ay, bendiga, mi hija.
Misión.
Yo te bendiga, mi cielo.
Okay. Okay, everybody, come in. Okay, everybody, if we could just have a seat. Okay, we can all just have a seat. We can get started.
Sit down!
Dominicans, you need to speak the language.
Well, it's okay. I have it. It's Spanish.
Has to put the camera here. So I put the camera here.
Sandra's gonna be back very soon, and I'm sure
she's. Hay un problema? ¿Qué problema que hay? ¿Qué es lo que hay que arreglar aquí? ¿Qué es lo que hay que arreglar aquí? Vuelvo y repito.
No, just a small technical delay, that's all.
Eso es cosa de técnico. Oh, pero el hijo de mi vecina arregla todo con un pedazo de té y un alicate. ¿Tiene té?
I'm fine, thanks.
Yo de este negocio no sé, no sé de cámara ni de luces. Pero yo creo que ustedes tienen que poner la cámara donde tiene que estar antes de yo sentarme aquí. Mi nombre es Dorca Elena Núñez Mateo. Y vengo de un país muy bello que se llama República Dominicana. Y yo nací en un pueblecito que se llama La Piña. ¿Qué quieren saber más de mí? Yo vengo de una familia trabajadora, sensible, humilde, que nunca le ha causado problema a nadie. Cuando yo tenía 5 años, yo me caí de un burro y no lloré. Ni siquiera cuando me estaba poniendo los puntos. Y eso fue en La Piña. No es que yo me crea especial, pero es que yo soy así y así nací.
Oh, wow. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Melky?
Mira, el día que esa niña nació, me dijeron, nació un angelito. Pero eso tú sabías yo que eso era un angelito.
Okay.
Parecía un ángel bajado del cielo.
What do you feel about how Melky's doing in her life right now?
Ahora, en la fiesta de Semana Santa, lo que ustedes le dicen es Spring Break.
No, I meant...
O quizá ella está aquí. ¡Melky! ¡Melky!
No, she's not here. I meant, could you talk about her situation a little bit?
Bueno, de la situación de Melky te diré que yo he tratado de guiarla por buen camino. Que estudie primero que todo, que eso es lo que yo quisiera. Que mi hija se me graduara de doctora. Y que se me consiga un buen hombre.
I meant about her drug problem.
¿Droga? Mi nieta no coge droga. ¿Tú estás loca? ¿Qué es lo que tú te crees?
Mrs. Mateo, you clearly signed a release form about last week about your granddaughter doing drugs.
Mi nieta no coge droga. Y que le caiga un rayo todito si mi nieta coge droga.
Mirando ahí.
Right, okay, but, like, can we cut a second?
No.
Last week you agreed to participate in an intervention which would help your granddaughter get off drugs. Remember?
¿Y qué?
Okay, how about this? Now, do you feel that Melky's doing good in school right now, or not so good?
Perfecto!
All right then, I think that's all that we need for today. Thank you. You're great.
Wonderful! Okay, ¿quién quiere comida? Mira tu flaco, vamos a comer. Que allí tengo yo pernil, arroz, habichuela, carne, yuca, tostones, hasta aguacate dominicano que me trajo mi prima.
Hey! Look, whoever's stupid idea this was, you're wasting your time. I can do this shit all day.
Well, your father said.
Oh, it was my father's stupid idea, of course! My father is the king of stupid ideas. It's his one claim to fame.
But he seems very concerned about
you. Does he really? Look, lady, you're in way over your head. Just wait, you'll see.
Sorry, we just need one more minute.
Oh yeah, take your time, mommy, take your time. The whole creative process, I get it, I'm down. You mind if I smoke?
Actually, Angus over there is allergic.
No shit, man. Wow, you should get that looked at.
So if you don't mind.
Oh. My bad, sorry. I bet they have a pill for that. Cure you just like that. You should look into that. You know something? I haven't been sick since 1994. You know why not? Mental control, Poppy. Mental control. I read a book about that.
Okay, Mr. Papos, we're ready.
Great. Anybody wants one of these bad boys? Actually, yeah, man, I'll have one.
No, thank you, we're working. And it's 10 a.m.
Oyela, ¿qué vaina es?
Mr. Papos.
I know, I get it. I know the whole routine. This was my idea, by the way. The whole intervention thing. I know my daughter like the back of my hand. We're tied like this. I know when she's sad, when she's cold, or hungry. I know when she's crying in the dark with only this the stars above to comfort her. Did you know that that male coyote could be as far as 20 miles and they know when the little ones, it's in danger? That's what I am, a male coyote.
So, Mr.
Como Cheche.
So, Cheche.
Cheche, Zar.
You feel close to your daughter.
The love that I feel in my heart for her is like a thousand suns shining down on a little flower. It's like daggers pinching in my heart. It's like a herd of wild horses galloping on a field of sunflowers.
So you're saying you have strong feelings?
I'm a very passionate man. I have feelings all over the place. You could ask anyone who knows me.
Don't ask.
That's why I'm not gonna lose her to drugs or to booze or to boys that do not know how to wear pants. All that. That's why I call you guys. That's why you people are here. To rescue my little girl from the forces of evil. But in the actual intervention, I drew a 4-part plan. Give me a second.
Oh, okay. Actually, well, you should talk to the interventionist about that.
You're not the interventionist?
No, I'm the producer.
Oh. The producer. So, what do you do?
I produce the show.
That sounds like a very important job, Mommy. And I'm sure you're doing an amazing job at it. But I gotta go. By the way, do you have the number for the interventionist? No.
My friends was Mr. Kenny G, my go-to man when I want to relax. Relaxing is a big part of my day. I try to do it in 10-minute sessions 2 to 3 times a day, never after meals though. Do it after a big lunch, sometimes you knock right out, wake up 8-10 hours later and it's like, where the hell am I? Am I right? You asked me what makes me a good interventionist. What qualifies little old me to step right into a stranger's life, just waltz right in like I'm Superwoman and suddenly become possibly the single most important person they have ever met? Well, I'll tell you what qualifies me. I've been there. Surprised? I've been there and back, and then there again, and back again, and back and forth, and back and forth, and back and forth. So many times I know the routine, I know the drill.
I know the mind of the addict, right?
Because I have an addict's mind. But Dr. Barb, isn't an addict's mind all full of holes and stuff on account of all the drugs they took to poison themselves with? Well, maybe so, but it could just be those holes are exactly what allows me to get in there and instantly understand the mind of the addict and their families. Because addiction is a family disease. I have a family. And all families are the same, even in their differences. And I'll tell you, I never met a family I couldn't sit down with and whip in a shape with a little understanding and insight and a whole lot of good old-fashioned tough love. So like they say, kickboxing group, bring it on, ladies. And bring it on strong.
Well, what about your mom? She seems very...
What? Uptight? Neurotic? Headed for a lockdown mental ward? You see, here's the thing about my mom. She pretends to be this singing in the choir, no elbows on the dinner table kind of person, when she's really not. That's not the real her. Trust me, I know. I've seen the pictures. So, she can accuse me of whatever she wants. At least I'm not pretending to be someone I'm not.
Are you comfortable?
I'm fine.
Can I get you a glass of water, or?
I said I was fine, thank you.
Pero bueno.
You had a crazy hair. Do you want people to see you with crazy hair on your head?
I do not have any crazy hair.
Sorry. My sister. Never mind. So, how do we do this?
Well, I was going to ask a few questions about yourself.
This is not about me.
No, I know.
This is about my daughter.
Well, you're obviously concerned about Melky.
Yes, I'm very concerned. I would do anything for my daughter.
I would cut off my arm for her.
I would shave my head bald.
Anything.
I would burn this house down to the ground for my baby. Do you understand me?
She will too. That is not a figure of speech. She burned down a classroom once. Science.
Eva, that was an accident. I was not.
Those poor frogs.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Sigue. Go. Mas. Sigue. What I was trying to explain before my sister so rudely interrupted is that even though my daughter and I are not in speaking terms right now, she and I are like two peas in a pod. We are like soulmates. And I know that this is all my fault. Maybe it was all that Mountain Dew that I drank when I was pregnant. Or maybe it was because I told her to get over herself when she was 13. I don't know. And now she's out there doing who knows what to who knows who to get her drugs or something. I don't know.
¿Y quién te dio ti permiso, coño, a toparme? ¿Y quién tú eres, coño? ¿Hijo de la gran puta? ¡Oh! ¡Mardito!
Unlike some people, I have a real job. And I don't have time for this mojiganga that you've got going on. So this can be rescheduled, right?
No problem.
I missed my Pilates today, okay?
AP Chemistry, AP Algebra, AP Physics, I'm also in the math club, so.
Wow, that's a lot of math.
Yeah.
Well, seems like you like math.
I guess so.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about your sister?
I'm sorry, I don't think I can do that. No.
Why not?
Because I just don't think it's that cool to talk about people, so.
Okay, but you know that your family's very concerned about her, right?
Yeah. Well, you know, maybe if they just left her alone, you know, backed off a little bit.
Now, why do you think she needs to be left alone?
Because she says it constantly. She's saying that. She said, leave me alone.
Leave me alone!
Leave me alone!
Leave me alone.
She says it just like that.
Well, maybe your sister's just one of those people that doesn't know how to ask for help.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, she knows how to ask for everything else, right? Or just take it. Not that I mind. I mean, she could have anything of mine that she wants.
And what type of stuff of yours does she take?
But every time my mom kicks her out of the house, Melky takes one of my t-shirts to think about me, she says. So that's cool.
Do you miss her when she's not home?
Yeah. It's pretty quiet, you know? It's like...
Jupiter, do you think that your sister needs help?
Yeah, sure. Everybody needs help, right?
Jupiter, today is your day. I'm going to take you to a whorehouse to make you a man. Enough is enough. When you're gonna start playing baseball? You're Dominican, Papi. You're Dominican blood inside of you.
You could be. How many times I have to tell you? I was born in this country. I'm American. I'm American first.
Por favor, Papi. You're Dominican like your Papi.
Why can't you understand that? Why can't you just see baseball? You know I don't like baseball.
Papi, baseball is God. That was made by the gods.
Dad, where are we going?
I was gonna take you to lose your virginity, but obviously you're not into that, so I am gonna go to the library.
I'm sorry. I was just messing with you. That was pretty good though, right? I can hold that shit for like 20 minutes, dude. I do this to my mom all the time. It drives her crazy. You should have seen her face though. What do you think? I was having like a seizure or something. OD, brain cells flying right before your very eyes. That's what you're hoping for, right? That I flip the switch or slip my wrist? Or drive my car into a tree or something while the cameras are rolling?
Absolutely not. That's not at all what we want.
Please. You know damn well that kind of stuff is great for ratings.
Malky, as I explained to you before, this is not a television show. This is a slice of life documentary.
Sure, dude, whatever. You want me to pretend I'm a moron? Fine by me. So this is the part where I'm supposed to say, hi, I'm Melky and I'm a drug addict. Right, like that, right?
Is that how you would describe yourself?
No. I describe myself as a rebel.
Yes.
An outcast. Black. Stubborn. Bitch.
This is stupid. Are you seriously going to record me all day?
Fierce guitar player. Cheater at cards. Great sister.
Thank you.
I'm just a 18-year-old misunderstood Dominican chica trying to find her place in the world.
But not as a drug addict.
I don't describe myself as a drug addict because that's everyone else's job, apparently. Just give me one second, please. Sorry.
Who was that?
Nobody. Oh, my drug dealer. Mind your fucking business! I can tell you've never done this before. You have that new car smell all over you.
I haven't done this exact job, but I have experienced a very similar field.
Yeah? What field would that be?
It was at the San Diego Zoo. I did some documentary work there.
The zoo? Oh. Wait, so you're telling me your experience is in observing monkeys and shit? Which naturally, no doubt, led to you observing me and my family?
No, absolutely not. That's not at all what I'm saying.
Do they know about this, my family?
I didn't really find it relevant.
You know what? I think I'm finally on board with this whole thing. I can't wait till they find out. Wait till that shit hits the fan. Then, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be the least of your problems.
Good luck.
I mean that.
Sorry, yo. My manager has some last minute business needing my attention. I was saying, my sincerest apologies. As a professional person, I try to be on time.
We're just getting ready to roll.
Right on. You peoples do your thing! You think some jugs might soften it up in here? Those floods you're rocking are pretty damn bright.
The floods are bright? The floods? They can see that show he's wearing from outer space? And I'm not his manager. Manage what?
Ma!
I ask you.
Ma!
Okay, mijo. I love you.
I love you, baby.
You guys can edit that shit out, right? No one wants to see that.
Of course. Not a problem.
Fuck, I lost it. Thanks a lot, Ma. I had this whole performance ready. I stayed up all damn night practicing it.
Performance? We don't need you to perform, Hector.
You don't? But I thought this was a movie.
This is a documentary. We just want you to be you.
Just be me.
Open and honest.
I don't think I could do that around her.
Well, I'm not leaving.
Just try your best.
Okay. Open and honest.
Just say what you're thinking right now.
What I'm thinking right now?
Yep, right now.
I'm thinking you got a juicy looking ass.
Oh, no. Been a disgusting vergüenza.
Ow!
Well, I see I'm gonna have to take over this. Because that boy is surely lacking a father figure at the moment. And my latest husband, ese sinvergüenza, hightailed to Boca Chica last month with a 20-year-old waitress from Dennis. Una puta estúpida. Ojalá que se puran los dos en el infierno. Mira, anyway, what do you want to know? ¿Qué tú quieres saber?
I just want you to tell us about Malky. Do you feel as if she has a drug problem?
Let me put it to you this way, okay? That girl dresses all in black like a Satan worshiper. Sunglasses in the house. Strange friends. Sneaker bars for lunch, and she listens to this music that makes you want to drown yourself in your own bathtub. I mean, you can even dance to that noise. I'm not here to judge. You draw your own conclusions. But I tell you this, that girl has changed. When she was little, she would let me brush her hair all day long. Not like Hector over there. You touch that boy's hair, and he'll throw your TV out the window. No, for real. I breastfed that boy until he was 4. Do you think that was my idea?
That's it. I'm out of here. And I forbid you to use any of this. You use a single thing she says, and I'm gonna sue.
Is he okay?
He's okay. He's not gonna sue. He doesn't even know what that means. He's just my precious baby boy. You know, sometimes he still sleeps on my bed.
Now, we're all here today because we're concerned about Melky.
¿Quién es esa mujer tan fea con esos moños tan feos?
This is the doctor.
¿A mí que esa mujer no es doctora?
Are we all okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Everything's okay.
See, I was just letting her know that you're the doctor.
Well, actually, I was just getting to that part. For those of you who don't know, my name is...
She's the best.
Dr. Bart.
She's the best. She's an expert on what she does. So people, just relax, okay? She got her degree, like, from Harvard, right?
Well, I don't have an actual degree.
So you're not a real doctor? Is that what you're trying to tell us?
Te lo dije, que esa mujer no era doctora, no sabe no habla.
No. That's not what she meant. Right, you are an intervention doctor, right?
That is exactly right. And as an intervention doctor, my qualifications are from life lived.
Let's just cut to the chase. Are you gonna fix Melky?
I am going to do my best.
You heard her. So people, relax.
Now, I think it's important that you all keep in mind that addiction is a disease.
Oh, like cancer or diabetes. You know, Herpes even.
Oh gosh, Chip.
You know what? I got something I gotta say.
Mr. Campos, if you could just allow me to... It's gonna take a minute.
It's gonna take a minute. It's something very important that I think that a room here will benefit of what I have to say. Now, senorita, we all have gathered here in this wonderful event.
You're gonna make toast?
No.
He's gonna make huevo con la comida.
What are you doing?
There you go. There you go. Oye, mi hijo. Toma aquí. Pepa. Toma ahí, mi sobrino querido del alma.
Porque se llama un party.
Yeah. Oh. Mommy.
Here you go, mommy.
Mr. Campos, I really don't think it's appropriate to have alcohol at an intervention.
Thank you.
This is not really alcohol. It's sparkling wine. Sparkling wine never hurt anybody.
Oh, really? Last time I had sparkling wine, this was the spring of 92, I ended up getting arrested for public intoxication, indecent exposure, and biting the ear off a police dog.
Okay, maybe none for you then. Anyways, like I was saying, we all gather here in this wonderful event, and it warms my heart to be surrounded by my beautiful family. Except Melky, as you all know, she's out there fighting for her life.
She's at Dunkin' Donuts. I just got a text.
And I want to dedicate this toast to my beautiful wife, Marisela.
Ex-wife.
And I want you to know that I noticed that you changed your hairdo.
I changed everything, okay, Cheche?
And that this hairdo, it's very nice, and it frames your face nicely. And I want you to know that I noticed that you changed your hair, because in the past, not me noticing things, it was a thorn in your side. Gracias. Salud.
Salud.
Dije,
mi hija, que siempre todavía te quiere.
Mami, please.
Melky was born Melquiades Indiana Campos. Melquiades is my father's name. See, we had this neighbor named Claudia. She had this crazy long fingernails and this purple hair and this bald-ass cat named Mangu. And she could read your fortune in a teacup. And she told us that we were gonna have a boy. She was wrong. Well, she wasn't wrong. She was just off by a few years, because eventually we had Jupiter. But you cannot be off with that stuff, man. What if you tell someone that they're gonna die and then they go off and do a whole bunch of crazy things because, hey, I'm gonna die soon. But instead, it takes 5 years. Oh, I just had sex with the first person I saw because I'm gonna die. Hey, I punched the Pope because I'm gonna die. I just smoked a bunch of crack because I'm gonna die. That's fucked up. Anywho, the moment Melky was born was the happiest moment of my life.
The moment that Melky was born, do you know what your chair was? He was in the corner bar getting busted for being drunk and disorderly.
People shouldn't talk shit about the mess, okay? Coño!
I remember lying there in a hospital bed, thinking to myself, you just had a child with a man who thinks that Jersey and New Jersey are two different places. Then I saw her. And she was beautiful.
I changed diapers. I did the butt cream and all. I made bottles, I got burp all over me. I handled all that shit. And I was employment deprived at the time. So, me and Melky, we're together a lot. You know what? I was a natural. A natural. Babies love me. I'll tell you what. I am the baby whisperer. And she wasn't too bad either. And anytime she got too worked up, I put a little whiskey in her milk and boom, boom, boom. I look like.
He put whiskey in her bottle? He put whiskey in my bottle?
What? Abuela taught me that trick.
Yo no sé de esa vaina. I plead the fifth.
Important thing is to just keep the cameras rolling, because this is a drug addict you're talking about. I'm crazy. crazy things can happen at the drop of a hat, all right?
Oh. Drop of a hat, yeah. That's quick.
You know what? You film people are really sneaky. I'm sorry, Maricela. I think there's been a misunderstanding. I mean, we're supposed to just shoot a typical life in the day of Melky, and now all of these people are here.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. You think I wanted this? I just had these floors waxed. But, you know, that's the way it is. Dominicans, they have a little bit of a sixth sense. And they make it their business to be with the action.
Hey! Hey! Abro, nachos, platanitos, chips, everything.
Yeah.
What up, Andus?
Pachuca. So what's up, people?
Cheche,
what are these people doing in my house?
What do you mean, these people?
They're our relatives.
Platanito, papi, you better.
Abba! Cheche, this is supposed to be about Melky. What makes you think that this film crew is interested in a whole bunch of the random Dominicans sitting in my living room?
What are you talking about, huh? This is a family thing. This is a family thing. And these people are here to love and support us in our time of crisis.
Oh,
and besides, here's my love of the party.
Oh, I didn't.
Oh, please. Two shots of tequila, and this one right here, being top of the table. Flatten her dead back!
About, especially you.
Okay, vamos arriba. So what's up? Dime a ver, parecía bueno, dice que la hacen.
No me digas que tú eres aguilucho.
¿No soy yo?
Tú eres
aguilucho, pero me acá. Nada más dos equipos, mi hermano, las águilas y Mets all the way. No me hables los Yankees, coño. No me los Yankees, hola de voto. ¿Qué? ¿Qué lo que es? Mets all the way.
What do you mean?
City Field.
No, no,
City Field.
City Field?
Bro, ven acá. Am I, what, bitch? I think con quien, con canca.
City Field.
City Field, baby.
¿Tú me has ido a City Field?
¿Quién te dijiste que no?
¿A dónde quedó City Field?
En Flushing. Al lado del Chester.
Del Chester.
Al lado del Chester. ¿Dónde está?
Meanwhile, I don't even know where Melky is.
I just called her. She's at her room at her grandmother's.
Suyo, mami. Abre the damn door.
¿Qué pasa? ¿Quita esa cara de burro que tú tienes?
Mami, is my daughter here?
No, tu hija no vive aquí.
Does she have a room here?
No, ella no tiene room aquí porque esta es mi casa.
Mami, if I find out that Melky is here after I threw her out of the house and I'm practicing tough love here, I am going to be very, very upset.
Juro, mi hija, por la Virgencita de la Altagracia, que tu hija no vive aquí. Ella no vive en la casa, ella vive en el basement. ¿Y para qué sirve el basement si no es para que mi nieta viva? ¿Este viejo está incómodo conmigo después que yo le hice sacar todos los discos de aquí? ¿Qué es lo que quiere este viejo? Total, si no sirve para ni pa' fu, ni pa' fu, ni pa'. ¿Qué es lo que te pasa a ti? Sigue llevándolo donde tú quieras llevarlo, mi hijo, que a mí eso me da igual. Tú sabes que yo he vivido mi vida muy bien, sin ti.
Does Melky do drugs in the house?
¿Por qué tenías tú que hacerme esa pregunta a mí si teníamos una conversación tan grata y tan dulce? ¿La dañaste?
Mrs. Mateo, I just want to know if...
Yo no soy la policía. Yo respeto su privacidad y ella respeta la mía. Junto, pero no revuelto. Yo le doy su dinerito para que ella se vaya al cine. Pero dije yo no sé más nada, corazón. Más nada.
Where is Melky right now?
Melky está en la librería ahora porque a mi nieta le fascina leer. Esa niña le gusta leer. Esa niña, tú me ves a mí media vieja, así ella es la que me... Y estoy media cegata, así como tú me ves. Ella es la que me lee el periódico. Y me lee mi novelita y me dice, mi niña es una niña ejemplar.
What? This is a library. Can't you see my book?
As a young girl, she was smart, talented, ambitious. She wanted to conquer the world, just like her mama.
Oh, she was like a mini JJ, the life of the party. She'll light up the room. Oh my God. Totally fierce. Not afraid to buck the system. She was like the sun I always wanted.
She always had good grades, good behavior, the perfect angel.
And then that shit with her mother happened.
And then her father did what he did.
I mean, all of a sudden, the woman lost it.
He was involved with 3 or 4 other women. Ay, que se yo cuanta otra mujer.
What? I cannot have female friends? Psst. This is the thing. I'm a people person.
He used that people person line on you guys too.
Check my Facebook.
Okay.
Look, we all have our foibles. Nobody's perfect, right? Even Marisela. Did she tell you she's missing a toe?
That is absolute. I have a slightly... You know what? I'm not even talking about this, no. Mm-mm.
Not perfect. Sacando lo trapito al sol.
I try to come out here at least once a week. Gives them something to get worked up about. They won't actually come out here while I'm here, though. They wait till I leave, then they ransack the whole place looking for my hidden drug supply.
So, Melky, where is your hidden drug supply?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Seriously, just for a second. What do you guys normally do when something like this happens?
When something like this happens, this shit wouldn't happen.
She signed release papers. I mean, she's agreed to let us film her. Oh, great. Now there they go. Where are they going? Seriously, again? Okay, they're going in the door. Let's go
We're on it.
Come on.
Marisela should be arriving right now.
There she is.
You see that? She's a very punk person. She's always on time, always. She follows a strict schedule. She thinks it's a sign of character. I disagree. I say having a routine is how they get you.
How who gets you?
You know, anybody who wants a piece of you. See, I zigzag when I go to places. I come in and leave places at random. I have everybody at their toes. I haven't been mugged, not even once. And anybody who's ever been looking for me has found me because I let them. So my friend, that's a free tip for you. Always zigzag. Ooh, she looking good today. Okay, she checks her mail, hi to the neighbor, and heads inside. Same thing every time.
Do you and Jupiter spend a lot of time doing this?
Jupiter's here.
He was supposed to drive me to a science club meeting, so I...
Come on, Poppy. Science club? I am saving you from this aburrimiento, muchacho. Poppy, do me a favor. Give me a fría.
Okay.
My man. So what was your question? Do I spend a lot of time doing what?
Well, watching Maricela.
Hey, excuse me? I'm not watching Maricela. I'm watching out for Maricela. And my family. It's my job. What kind of a man you think I'll be if I just let them to their own devices? My family needs me. They might not say it, they might not admit it out loud, but they're like breaking to pieces over there without me. You think my daughter would be running wild if I were over there taking care of shit? Huh? No. And look at that, look at that. Shingles falling out of the roof and everything. Ay, Dios mío. You know when was the last time they mowed the lawn? Huh? Do you? 37 days. And you know how I know that exactly? Because 37 days ago, I'm on it personally. I had to sneak over there in the middle of the night, but I got it done. Well, maybe I missed a few patches here and there, sure. I'm not Spider-Man, I kinda see in the dark. But look at that. I think I did a hell of a job under the circumstances.
The lawn does look pretty good.
Yes, it does, doesn't it? There she goes. Hey, watching over my back.
This is not a motel, okay? Tell her that I needed some of my stuff.
She said that
Mira,
she needs some.
Cállate, San Desto. That gives you no excuse, no excuse at all for you to go around sneaking. Sneaking? I'm the sneak. Ask her who's been in my room sneaking through my stuff.
Try milking. Milky, try milking.
No.
Try it. I love drugs. Try it. Try marshmallows. Marshmallows.
What kind of passwords are these?
What? She likes marshmallows.
Please, mommy. I got this. This is all about deduction.
My boy, he's a thinker.
Get a job! I have no reason to go around snooping around your things, okay? And I know that you think that you're hurting me by not speaking to me. But you're only making yourself look childish. I mean, look how rude you're being. You haven't even introduced me to your little friend.
I've introduced her to Lisa like 1,000 times. And every time, my mom is like, oh, I didn't recognize you.
Oh, Lisa, I'm sorry. I didn't recognize you.
You changed something. Maybe your hair.
It must be because you changed your hair.
No. Or maybe your clothes.
Well, you're wearing your clothes so differently.
It's still the same. See, if my mom can't deal with something, she just pretends it doesn't exist. Like they say, denial ain't just a river in Egypt.
Oh, now I remember you. Of course I do. Mira. ¿Qué tipo de maneras son esas, Melky? Oh, pero bueno, pero bueno.
So the idea here is to write the note in a form of a letter.
All right, listen up, people. letter. Write it down.
And the important thing is to make the letter personal.
You got that? Personal. Tell her something embarrassing about yourselves.
Actually, what I mean when I say personal is that you use the letter to let Milky know how her behavior is impacting you.
What? Let's do this. Vamos, pa' hoy. Escriban.
Can I start my letter with holla?
Sure.
It's customary to start your letter with a simple dear so-and-so.
Data. Facebook.
Mr. Campos, mm-hmm. I notice you're not writing.
Ah, I have the entire letter right up here. There is no need to write down anything. I have a photographic memory.
What's the matter? What do you eat the plátano?
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't speak Spanish. Korean, German, and a little bit of Maori, but sadly no Spanish.
She's just wondering why you're not eating.
Oh, I'm on a special gluten-free, lactose intolerant, vegan raw food diet.
Okay, mommy, she ate earlier. Okay, yo comí hace.
Eso no fue lo que ella dijo.
Let me just write your letter.
you did that? That's right.
Che-che.
Oh. Okay. I write it down, girls. Don't worry about it. I have it all down, right here. Escribe. Oye, tiene tu cartón. No el mío. Remember, ex mujer. Tiene tu cartón, que no tiene nada que ver conmigo.
I already wrote my letter.
I'm done.
Te lo vas a comer. Te lo vas a comer. Pop it. Just remember.
Pop it. I received. She kicked me out of my own house. How do you think that made Milky feel, huh? She was totally confused.
She was totally devastated.
I was totally relieved. They were like a nightmare together. I mean, seriously, you've met them, right?
Overnight, Milky changed. She started getting moody, dressing weird. And then, she got herself kicked out of the choir.
She dropped the choir.
For God's sake, the choir.
And she has a beautiful voice, just like her mama does. Wanna hear?
Si pudiera, te dijera que te fueras de mi vida. Si pudiera, te mandara.
I was never actually in the choir. I just told my parents that because this sounded better than, hey mom, I'm going to the park to hang out with some stoner friends and roll tires down the hill into traffic and, or whatever.
And then, the final straw. She drops out of school.
Finally, last month, I said, that's it, I've had it. If you wanna go ahead and run around with your crazy friends, fine, you can do it, but not here. Not in my house, not with my rules. Go, ya, vete, pa fuera, get out.
So her mom kicked her out. She has a thing about kicking people out of the house, huh? But still, I couldn't blame her. The way Milky changed.
I didn't change, okay? You wanna know what happened? I stopped pretending is all. I stopped pretending I was the girl they wanted me to be, and I stopped pretending that I wanted to be the girl they wanted me to be.
So, who do you want to be?
How am I supposed to figure out who I am while I'm surrounded by all these people who have already decided? I'm out of here.
Can you explain to me what's going on right now?
Oh, I'd love to, but we're looking for Milky. We haven't seen her in a very long time, okay?
You don't have to look at the camera while you're driving. You should look straight ahead. It's not really safe.
You're a very nervous person, ain't you, huh? Have you tried any supplements? Huh? Any herbal supplements?
For nerves?
Oh, yeah, for everything. You need that for everything. There you go. Gracias, papi. Anyways, we haven't seen or talked to Milky in over an hour. You know what that means?
What does that mean?
It means that she could be anywhere. She could be hurt. She could be dead. But she could be also halfway around the world by now.
Realistically, though, it's only been an hour.
Hey. My daughter's a very smart person. What she does in an hour takes people a whole day to do it. What can you do in an hour? Oh, shit! There she is!
Oh, crap.
No! I cannot stop here and keep watching you do this to yourself!
That was sort of bad! You can't stay watching me clear my nasal congestion?
It's breaking my heart! It's breaking my heart! Literally, I can feel the blood spraying inside of me! Come home and stop doing this to yourself and stop destroying yourself! What you have in front of you here is a broken man! Broken by the addiction of his daughter! And have eaten a hole in his soul!
Yep, Sudafed.
I need a drink.
The thing is that I get an idea. And they'll just take and take. I have love pouring out of me like a flowing river. And she turns away from my love. I know it's hurting her too. I know it. And right now she's walking the dangerous streets out there.
Actually, I just talked to her and she's fine.
She's suffering like a wounded bird.
No, she's at home. She's okay.
Lies!
It's a mask. It's a facade. I know the real Milky that's hiding inside.
Okay, let's just drive you home. Yeah.
You can leave this place. I just put quarters in the jukebox. Oh yeah, mommy. Wanna dance? I'm okay. Give me 5 minutes.
Cheche. Great guy. Great father. He used to bring his kid here, put her to sleep on the pool table. I once saw him win a $5 bet, jumping a cue ball over his kid to hit a corner pocket shot. Crazy. Completely crazy.
See, here's the thing. All of the drug addict shows, they have shots with the drug addict using the drugs, okay? And we don't have any of these shots. Why don't we have these shots?
You are blocking the TV.
We just need to get these shots. We need to come up with some sort of game plan in order to get these shots.
What's this we stuff? You're the producer. It's your job. Produce.
I know exactly what my job is, thank you, but I was thinking maybe I could get some input from you guys. I mean, maybe you guys had some game plans that you used with Sandra. Oh.
Sandra! I thought we weren't supposed to mention Sandra. I thought Sandra was taboo.
You know what? I'm taking a bath.
So let me get this straight. You would like me to take some drugs for the benefit of the camera?
No, I mean, if you were planning on doing drugs throughout the course of the day, maybe you could just let us know so we could document it.
Like a text?
Yeah, actually a text would be perfect. Yeah, I can give you my number and then you can just text me any time.
Classic. Addict. They hide their behavior, practically the definition of addiction.
Esa muchacha es un poco rarita. I told my kids, listen and learn. There is the right way and there is the other way. You do the other way and I'm going to send you to the hell.
As a creative thinker and a talented person, I myself have dabbled in the chemicals. There's a difference between dabbling and losing all self-control. Even though losing control could be a little fun, you know what I'm saying?
She's always had a problem with authority. Is she here?
Bacon and ice cream? Who eats that?
Tell her to call me. I'll help her.
She wouldn't dare do drugs in front of me. But I know what I know. I'm her mother.
What am I doing? Blowing smoke, assholes. This is such bullshit! All that ass is a brother called.
Watch your language. I don't want you behind the wheel.
Wine!
Oh, you know why. She's lying. I don't know exactly about what, but I know that she's lying.
How can I help?
How do you always know what's going on over here?
It's intuition.
It's creepy.
What you doing?
Nothing. All I want was a brolly car for one night to go to Gladys 316 in Jersey.
I thank you. Done. Oh. Quality time with your daughter. And the family in Jersey throw some slabby parties.
Lean the
what? I'm just helping.
Lean the Lean.
You forgot to carry the one.
I, please.
You got coffee? I'm out. Ooh.
Te saliste con la tuya.
Café Santo Domingo.
Man, this brings back some memories. Going back to a good old Dominican bash. Melky and me, best buds. Hey, Melky, remember we used to do this all the time when you were little?
You mean when I was like 3? When you dragged me to parties and dumped me on a couch somewhere? That's your idea of best buds? Dumping me on a couch with a pack of gum and some quarters while you go and hang out with your friends?
That's right. She used to love quarters.
Yeah. I swallowed at least 4.
Hey, check this out. Sometimes, at a parking meter, I will hold her upside down and pretend to shake some coins out of her.
He wasn't pretending.
Oh, we had some good times. Look at us now. Cheche and the Milkster, back of style.
I don't want to go to Clara's stupid party. Latino and Jose, please. All I wanted was to park for one night to meet some friends in the city.
Jersey, here we come. Jersey, here we come. Party! I'm gonna sing for you.
No.
Mi melquisita, que chiquita más linda. Don't jump.
Are you ready to hit the town? Let's go.
Strange. Dance with a stranger.
Where have you been?
I've been taking a nap. What's up?
What's up, Mr. Campos, is that your daughter has kidnapped one of our cameramen.
Now, hold on a minute. Kidnapped a little far.
You be quiet.
She'll be back.
I don't think she's coming back. It's 5 a.m.
The problem is that you can't think like Noki. You can't get in her head. It's like one of those TV shows, you know, where the detectives, they think like criminals. That's me, a TV detective. You smell bacon?
Why would that even matter?
Because Melky loves bacon.
Ah, up, sir.
I told you she'd be back.
Melky!
Thank you.
milk he was here.
Hey,
you think that he'll mind if I grab just a little bite of his sandwich?
Thank you, buddy.
Oh, Dios mío, pero como me ponen los chicles estos muchachos aquí, ¿cómo será que yo me voy a hacer, Dios mío?
We're putting the first camera that way. We're gonna probably do another camera.
Okay, honey, you're just gonna have to roll with it. Okay, this thing's gonna have a life of its own, and you just gotta let nature take its course.
Right, but can you just give me a general sequence of events?
Okay, it's like cage fighting. The rule is there are no rules. You ever throw down in a ring?
Okay.
You should. Okay, let's talk order of the letters.
Okay, this is what I'm thinking. Like, I'm the father. Mm-hmm. I'm the one who she's definitely gonna listen to. So I say, keep me like a secret weapon,
you know,
like that.
Fine, I will go first. I have a lot of things to say.
Okay, well, I don't think we're gonna have time for a long letter, so.
We better be making time. I'm gonna say what I am going to say.
Doesn't she look sexy when she's mad?
Yes, ooh. Yes, sexy.
Sexy, sexy, sexy.
People,
you drunk fool.
Oh.
Bebo! Oh, I love this song! I just love this song! Cha cha!
Bebo!
Listen, look! Dear Melky, you are hurting this family. I have written you this letter because you are hurting me. I am your mother. You need to understand what I am trying to tell you. Ven para tu casa, para que yo te deje estudiar. Yo soy tu mamá! Yo soy tu mamá! You're being a brat. Yes, a big, stinky brat. You want to turn out to be like your father?
Everyone has their trigger, right? Their Achilles heel, for me, it's a particular style of 80s pop tune that does something to me that I can't explain. It assaults me with groping hands, many, many hands, seeking out all the little corners of my... May I have a moment alone, please? You are a goddess. You run with the wolves. You are a goddess. You run with the wolves. You are a goddess. You run with the wolves. Now go out there and save the world, one addict at a time.
But I don't want to go to a stupid party.
Sure you do. Who doesn't want to go to a party?
Me, Hector. I don't want to go to a party.
But this is a surprise party just for you. And I'm not even supposed to tell you this, but your brother's going to give you a car! Woo!
You're so full of shit. Pull up and let me out.
Oh, you're going to this party.
Shh. They're coming. They're coming. Hector, make it through. Wake up. Wake up. Sit down. Come on. Here.
Okay. All right, don't touch me.
Remember, everyone, just act normal. We don't want to scare her off before we even get her in the door.
There she is!
Sweetheart! Bang!
That she was 3 years old.
How the hell do you know what goes on in my house?
Someone go after her. Relax, take it easy, hon. I got this part. Someone should go after her.
You know, I'll go. She'll listen to me.
Oh, yeah. No, Mia. If there's somebody that's gonna go after her, it's me. I am her mother, and she's gonna listen to me.
You're up.
Oh no. You know what? No, I don't think so.
You think you can handle it?
Yeah, I can handle it. Just let go of me, please. Stupid. Hey.
Hey.
You know this was not my idea, right?
please, obviously.
I'm sorry.
Can I talk to him in private, please? So they're freaking out?
Sort of.
Okay, look. I'm gonna go back in there. The last thing I want is you getting in trouble.
Okay, it's okay, look. You don't have to go back in there if you don't want to. If you don't want to do it, don't do it, please.
I want to. I have some things to say.
Are you sure?
Yes. I'm sure.
This is your last chance.
You see me walking back in, right?
You have to do this. If you don't do this, I'm gonna kill myself.
You're gonna kill yourself?
Yeah, I swear.
Everyone knows you're way too into yourself to kill yourself.
The truth is, if you do this, your mother and I get back together.
Oh, wait. I never said that. This is not part of this deal.
Hey,
no way.
You're not willing to do that for your daughter? She wants us together. She's practically begging
us. I am not.
Look at her eyes. She's making with the eyes. Eyes don't lie.
I got her. What do you mean?
I can play football. I can also juggle.
Get off of you, asshole!
Don't fight!
Yeah, girl, you can't win.
Whoa. Now you asking for it, boy. Take his ass. That's right, that's right. That's right. Go. Take him, get him. That's my girl.
There will be some resistance. If there wasn't, I'd be
out
of a job. Anyway, deep down, the addict knows their life is completely unmanageable. Is it me?
Or is that doctor missing some of her marbles?
She doesn't know what she's up against. My girl's not putting up with that. You just watch. Smart! Starting with the legal card.
Is it true? Are we gonna get sued? Okay, so you know, I met that demon personally. Although you probably can't tell by looking at me now. But I danced with that demon for many years. I myself was pronounced dead on multiple occasions. Interestingly, every time I died, I saw not the white light at the end of the tunnel, the golden arches of McDonald's. Junkies. They have such terrible eating habits.
Okay, baby! I'm calling 911!
Okay, I think we're ready to let her out now. Y'all better just take a step or two back, okay? Just in case she's still pissing.
Bam! Oh, touchdown! Machuca! What? No love for the old man?
Well, here we all are. A little bruised maybe, but no worse for the wear.
Sorry about your nose.
Whoa, that wasn't your fault. His job is to be on his toes. You gotta be more on your toes, man. You gotta open your eyes, stay loose.
Right, thanks.
See, I'm on your team, baby.
I don't want you on my team.
Okay, let's stay on point, folks. Melky, I've spent a little time with your family today, and as I've come to know them, I've come to realize
how much they love me, yada, yada, yada. Can we speed this up, please? You guys wrote me letters, right? So let's do this.
Okay. Dear Melky, your behavior has affected my life in the following ways.
I got mad skills while you be popping pills. All day long, we stay so strong. Fresh from the block.
My turn. Meth, your has me in the anything. Murky is crazy, wearing crazy clothes. I can read my own writing.
Pero muchacho, el carajo, tú sabes leer todavía. Con tanto dinero que yo he gastado en ti. Oh, Dios mío.
Okay, I'm just gonna continue. I feel that we no longer have a loving mother-daughter relationship.
You don't really bother me. I don't have really any complaints.
Stop being a druggie! I'll give you a snuggie!
I didn't write a letter, but I started to compose one mentally, and then I said to myself, Che, why do you have to write a letter to this girl when she's gonna be standing right in front of you? Just make her see with her eyes what's in your heart.
Che, please sit down, okay?
I'm not gonna sit down. She's my daughter and she needs my help.
You know what? She needs to see the reality of her situation,
what
okay?
What she needs is a kick in the ass.
Excuse me, but what the addict needs is to be controlled.
You don't know what I need. None of you know what I need.
You know what you need. You need to stop hanging around that little friend of yours.
Her name is Lisa. And stop calling her my little friend when you know perfectly what she's my girlfriend.
You're gay? Well, this is an exciting moment. Okay, I wasn't completely prepared for a gay situation, but I can wait. Melky, coming out to your family can be very difficult.
I'm not coming out to them. I've told them like 100 times.
What? When?
Like all those times when I said, hey Dad, this is my girlfriend Lisa.
That girl Lisa, are you sure she's your girlfriend?
Melky is not gay. She only says that because she wants to hurt me.
She never gave me the gay vibe. I'm usually very sensitive to this thing.
Oh, I knew she was gay. Chick wears combat boots.
Okay, I think we're getting off topic.
Oh my God, why can't you all just leave me alone?
Surprise!
Oh my God.
Hey, you told me there's a party here.
What? Hector said he was gonna tell Melky that it was a surprise party.
Yeah, but that don't mean you tell everybody else that.
That's
oh,
right.
So what? Come on, everybody loves a party.
Like, I don't know what to do anymore. My family's like crazy.
They're not crazy. They're fucking psycho.
That's my family you're talking about.
I'm just saying.
Okay, and I'm saying, yeah, maybe they're crazy and dysfunctional. And fucked up, but they love me. I mean, they wouldn't go through all the trouble to get me help if they didn't. Yeah, and maybe they are wrong, but they're doing it for a reason.
We just want to help you, okay?
You know, baby, I just want to fix your hair, buy your pretty dresses, you look nice. Like
my daughter, lo único que creo es que tú seas feliz, yo y toda tu familia, mi hija.
You know, I just want you to be happy.
Look at this family. What a beautiful family. Hey, somebody! Come and take a picture of this photogenic people.
to rehab, but only if you go.
Wait, me? What are you talking about? You think I need rehab?
Oh no, Milky, it's too late for him.
Whoa. Wait a second. Too late for me? Too late for what?
You can't teach an old dog new tricks. It's you, Mommy.
Hey!
It's you that I'm worried about.
What are you saying? You people think I have a drinking problem?
You drink all the time, Dad.
You got big problems.
Jesus Christ.
You got big problems.
You drink all day, every day, Chinche.
It's not like it's a problem or anything.
You can't hold down a job.
Cheche, mírame, Cheche. You cried my car. And ma, tú rompiste mi carro.
Yeah, and you threw up on my couch. Even though I've done it sometimes myself, but that was nasty, Cheche.
Yeah, you ate 4 pages out of my textbook. That was disgusting, man.
You were never there for me.
What? When?
Ever! You were never there for me!
Oh, shit. You guys almost got me there. You tried to turn this around to make me believe that I'm the one with the problem? You got me. That was funny. That was very funny. Then it was like I had an epiphany, you know, like a moment of total enlightenment. I looked at her standing there and I said to myself, that's my girl. That right there is the best thing I ever did. And you know what? I'd do anything for that girl.
Our philosophy here is that your surroundings have a significant impact on your chances of success of beating your addiction. That's why I run this program here at my country home. I want to bring people back to a simpler time, a time when we're more in touch with nature, more connected to the earth. I want to focus less on the talk therapy and more on the emotional. And what I found works best is using
goats. They cure people here with goats. Maggie.
It's not just goats. There's many different animals involved in our recovery program.
You know what I like about goats? They remind me of growing up as a kid in Santiago. My mom, she didn't want me to have a dog. So I snuck a goat into my bedroom and made believe that he was my dog. I named him Lassie, let him sleep in my bed. Oh, that goat was better than any dog. Did you know that they can live on socks and candy wrappers? Not for long, though.
We've been doing a lot of hard work with Cheche. Frankly, maybe a little bit too much hard work. But I'd like to think we're making progress.
The doctors here are great. What you're looking at is the new and improved Cheche. Sure, we bump heads at first, mostly because they let me have beer here. Not even light beer. I'm telling them, seriously, light beer is not really alcohol.
Light beer is most definitely alcohol.
But since I found my hookup, he's been smooth sailing ever since. Right, Kenny?
Don't get me fired.
Oye, papi, I get you another job. Go look and take it easy. I love rehab.
Now, Melky? Melky has been one of our greatest success stories. The fastest, most complete recovery this facility has ever seen.
That's because I never was a drug addict. I just figured this was the only way to get everyone off my back. And plus, I'm making some new friends.
We're so proud of Melky that we're thinking about putting her on the cover of our new brochure.
Yeah, that's never, ever going to happen. Unless, how much do you think I'd get paid? I would really like a motorcycle.
Oh, it's been a miracle. Really, it has. Having Cheche and Melky in rehab and out of the house, it's given me an opportunity to work on myself and on all of the things that I want. Oh, it's been a new beginning for all of us.
I hate new beginnings.
Work your core, Feva. Work your core.
And heart.
The world is all mine, and when I come out, it's gonna be so fine. As a matter of fact, having some addicts in the family definitely will give me some street cred. Yo, as I was saying before, when I knock on your door.
How about you, Jupiter? How do you feel about your relationship with your family now?
Great. I mean, everyone's getting along much better now, and it's just like, it's a nice feeling now, you know? There's no negativity, so. Well, just don't tell my dad I'm at science camp. He thinks I'm at baseball tryouts.
This intervention has been very important to me. I've had the unique experience and the opportunity of having my 7th relapse. Now, I'm on an ankle bracelet monitor. And I have 1 week sober.
Yo fui a visitar a Cheche y a Melky a la finca de los chivos. Yo creo que van a estar bien, pero no dejen que Cheche se acerque al avión, porque yo conozco ese tigre. Trust me.
See, this whole time I've been telling myself it's just like a car with wings, right? And who can't drive a car?
What did I learn? Always keep the cameras rolling.
Booyah!
When I fall back to sleep,
la muchacha?
She is a total enabler.
Ay, mami, please.
Mami. I saw you give Melky $20.
Do you see? Do you see? This is all your fault.
An issue, so I mean, now actually, she helps me pick up girls. Yeah, they're not the prettiest girls, yeah, but they're real, they're nice, they're good. It's cool, it's a good thing, right?
Okay, and Dominican scholarship.
That means she can make out with chicks in my videos. Oh, you already know that's gonna be hot. Hey, look, she's my cousin, right?
What was that?
What was what?
Eso!
Amiga, que Janice has got three nipples.
Don't try to distract me. You know what? When we hooked up, I was on antidepressants that made me oversexed and impaired both my vision and my judgment.
That's wrong. I make it.
Oh no, I'm sorry. I don't speak Spanish.
I make it in English.
Korean, German, and...
I make it in English.
She said that she made it with all the love in the world for you. That you're gonna save Milk. You cannot do that to an old lady who's sick and dying.
She's not dying.
Take it! Take it! You
know what I'm saying? Ya, vamos a firmar.
Estamos firmando.
¿Y
qué diferencia la mierda?
Está bien.
Ay, no, eso no se hace.
Ok, vamos a hacerlo otra vez.
Pero tiene que estar
metiendo la mierda. Sí, yo le quiero.
The mic is going to be showing like this, man. What kind of a documentary is on TV with showing the microphone like this? The van a acabar para allá, para Santo Domingo, a ti. Tú verás.
Señores, cada quien haga con su parte lo que le dé la gana. Coño.
Abuela? She's crazy.
Crazy.